हेलो, दिस इज डॉक्टर सेवाकांत पाठक हियर विथ यू टू सी वन मोर टॉपिक दैट इज परफेक्टली इलास्टिक कोलिजन इन वन डायमेंशन. सी, दिस इज टॉपिक विच वी आर गोइंग टू डील टूडे. इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर द साइंस ऑफ collision and its type we have seen clearly. In the elastic collision we have seen two laws are basically hold. The first one is law of conservation of momentum. Second, law of conservation of kinetic energy. These two conservation law hold in it. Clear? So, we will apply this conservation law to explain the perfectly elastic collision in one dimension. To discuss this, let us consider two ball A and B. Is according to a diagram. See what is the diagram here, it is given in it. Let us consider this is one dimension situation in a straight line here representing, and left hand side is situation is before collision. This is the situation of collision and it is after collision. Let us consider two ball A and ball B here. Ball A of mass m1 and ball B of mass m2 moving with velocity u1 and u2 in the direction, same direction. So two ball A and B having masses m1 and m2 moving with initial velocity u1 and u2. Here in this case initial velocity u1 is greater than u2 and collides. See the collision here. Ball A collides with ball B here. A and B collides. After collision, this ball A here moves in this direction with velocity v1, and ball B moves with velocity v2. See very carefully here in this case, two object A and B moving with uniform velocity u1 and u2 having masses m1 and m2 collides, and after collision their velocity becomes v1 and v2, in the direction shown in the diagram clearly. Now see, if we are considering it is completely perfectly elastic collision, so here in this the one point may also be keep in mind, that is no loss of energy in this case. So total kinetic energy before collision is equal to total kinetic energy after the collision, which is given in the second key point in the beginning. So these facts must be clear, right? Let us calculate something. The first thing we are going to calculate, that is the relative velocity of approach. See, relative velocity of approach. U1 and U2 are a velocity. U1 is greater than U2. Then we can write it is U1 minus U2. And can be represented as equation number 1. Thereafter, we are going to calculate relative velocity of separation. After collision, both separated and moves with velocity v1 and v2. So this can be written as v2 minus v1. So this is a relative velocity u1 minus u2 before collision, and it is after collision. We can write here in the bracket, this is the situation before collision and it is after collision. This is the situation. Now we want to see one more thing. I want to apply law of conservation of momentum. Since in perfectly elastic collision, law of conservation of momentum hold, that is total momentum before collision is equal to total momentum after collision. So we may write m1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. See, and this is represented by equation number 3 here in this case. So this is total momentum before collision and this is total momentum after collision. Now m2 u2 and m2 v2 I am keeping on left hand side, and m1 u1 and m1 v1 in right hand side. We may write m2 u2 minus m2 v2 is equal to m1 v1 minus m1 u1. Now here is a common m2. M2 we can take common. It is u2 minus v2 is equal to, here is m1 common, v1 minus u1. And I am going to take it as equation number 4. So see here, this equation is important in the further calculation. So I am going to keep here in a box. This is. Now see carefully. One more conservation law is hold here. That is law of conservation of energy. So right here, applying law of conservation of kinetic energy here, because on a single plane we are taking potential energy at every point is a constant, so no change in potential energy, only there is exchange in the kinetic energy only. So what is this? Total kinetic energy before collision is equal to total kinetic energy after collision. So here in this case, see very carefully, kinetic energy of ball A, half m1 u1 square plus ball B. This total kinetic energy before collision is equal to half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square. Write as equation number 5. Now same like as a previous conservation law, we are going to keep m2 terms on left hand side and m1 terms on right hand side. So we may write half m2 u2 square, keep this side, half m2 v2 square is equal to half m1 v1 square minus half m1 u1 square. Now half is everywhere, so we can cancel out this half here. Here in this m2 is the common, this is u2 square minus v2 square is equal to, m1 is common in right hand side, it is v1 square minus u1 square, and write it as equation number 6. See in the box. Now see next step here, here on the first page in the beginning. So come here on for a fresh page. Now what we are going to see, we are dividing equation 6 by this is 4. So left hand side divide by left hand side and right hand side by right hand side. It is m2 u2 square minus v2 square divided by here in left hand side on the equation 4 is m2 u2 minus v2 is equal to here m1 v1 square minus u1 square by m1 v1 minus u1. So here m2 is cancelled by m2 and m1 is cancelled by m1. Now it is a square minus b square, so a plus b, a minus b, so it is cancelled and remaining terms are here. See very carefully, u2 plus v2 is equal to v1 minus u1. V1 minus u1. See very, very, very carefully, it is now. And first of all, write it as a next equation number. This is equation number 7. This is positive here. So V1 plus U1. Now see, we can obtain some result by it. V1 transfer in this side, V2 minus V1. This above equation can be written as V2 minus V1 is equal to U1 minus U2. See V2 minus V1, when we see equation 2 in this case, it is equal to relative velocity of separation is equal to u1 minus u2. Relative velocity of approach. See this important result from equation 7. It means that one thing is important here in this case. Everyone can see no change in difference in velocity before the collision and after the collision. There is exchange of a kinetic energy, but one thing remains unchanged. What is that? Difference in the velocity. So relative velocity before separation always equal to relative velocity after the relative velocity of the approach. So this difference in the velocity remains the same. This is first important result. This can be asked to prove that in the one dimension case, this is a relative velocity remains the same. So this must be clear to everybody. One more important point, please see here. By this equation 7, we can write v2 minus v1 by u1 minus u2 is equal to 1. We are knowing it is also equal to E. This is coefficient of restitution. When I was in the theory of the elastic collision, I told to you for the perfectly elastic collision, the coefficient of restitution is 1. And it is proved by this concept, right? So this is the proof of the concept. This is for the perfectly elastic collision. So this collision is perfectly elastic collision. So for perfectly elastic collision, the coefficient of restitution is always 1. So it is proved by that, and this proof is obtained by these equations. Now we are going to calculate velocities after collision. Velocity after collision is v1 and v2. It means we are going to obtain for the formula of v1 and v2. So see very carefully what we are going to do in this case. Now see here equation 7 can be written as, this is v2 minus v1 is equal to u2 minus e1. I am going to transfer this v1 in another side, and we can write this is v2 is equal to u1 minus u2 plus v1. See this is, and this is equation number 8 we are using here. We are going to put this value in equation number 3. Now, putting the value of V2 in equation 3. See very carefully how things are transferred from left hand side to right hand side and calculated for it. So here it is. The third equation is for law of conservation of momentum, that is total momentum before collision is equal to total momentum after collision. So total momentum before collision is here given m1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. In place of v2 we are going to write m1 u1 minus u2 plus v1, right? So now opening the bracket m1 v1 plus m2 u1 minus m2 u2 plus m2 v1, and here in the left hand side is m1 u1 plus m2 u2. All v1 terms I am going to keep on the right hand side, and rest of the term, see here in this case underlined term, to understand it very carefully, this term I am transferring in the left hand side. See here m1 u1 plus m1 u2, when it is transferred here m2 u1 with negative sign, and it is when come in this side plus m2 u2 is equal to. The remaining terms are, see here, in both v1 is a common, we may write m1 plus m2 v1. See here, the underlined term is here m1 u2, m1 u1, this is m2 u2, m2 u1, this is u2 here, and it is u2 term is here. See, this is m1 u1 and m2 u1 is here. See here, it is m1 u1 and m2 u2, it is m2. Now see very carefully, u1 u1, we will take these two together, in which u1 is common, we can write m1 minus m2. This is m2 u2, m2 u2, m2 u2, we can write 2 m2 u2 is equal to m1 plus m2 v. By this equation we can obtain value of v1, it is v1. So it is u1 m1 minus m2 by m1 plus m2 plus 2 m2 by m1 plus m2 u2. This is formula to calculate the velocity here, and it can be represented by this equation. Now the we can obtain this equation for v1 also, and can put in the same equation and can solve the formula, or we may write similarly v2 is equal to, see the symmetry for here only. So what is the symmetry here? See, this is m1 minus m2, so it is m2 minus m1 for v2. In place of u1, keep u2 here by m1 plus m2 will remain same plus 2. Here is m2, so write here m1, then u1 here in place of u2, m1 plus m2, this is formula for velocity for the second ball. Now see the special case, some of the special cases, and here in this derivation the result of a special case is very important, and it only give the science, rest of things is the mathematics. Let both ball have equal mass, that is M1 is equal to M2 is equal to M. Let both is equal. Just before this we have derived the formula for velocity V1 and V2. So let's see in this page once more the camera. These are the equation. Here in this case, when we will apply this is mass is equal, in that condition M1 minus M2 term, this will be vanished. It will be vanished, and here only this term will be here only. By this equation 9 and 10 can be written as in this form, that is V1 is equal to 2M U2 by 2M. This implies that V1 is equal to U2 and V2 is equal to 2M U1 by 2M, and this implies that V2 is equal to U1. See these two important results which is given by both combinedly. One equation I am going to give here. This is equation number 10. See, this is a very much important result in this. So when two balls have equal masses moving with velocity U1 and U2 and collides, then after collision the velocity of ball B will be velocity of ball A, and velocity of ball A will be velocity of ball B. It means they will exchange their velocity. That is, the ball will exchange their velocities. This can be asked to prove in the exam, and this is a very important result here. How it is? So we will write the formula for both, and we will keep M1 is equal to M2 and derive, and we will see that, so that V1 is equal to U2 and U2 and V2 is equal to U1 here in this case. Now see the second special case. When target ball B is at rest, means ball B A is coming towards ball B. Ball A has velocity U1 and collides on a rest ball B. This implies that U2 is equal to 0. Then see what are the situations arises. So see what is the equation 8 and 9 comes. In that condition, equation 8 can be written as V1 is equal to, by keeping U2 is equal to 0, it will come M1 minus M2 U1 by M1 plus M2. This is equation number 11. And V2 is equal to came 2M1 U1 by M1 plus M2. So these are the formula in that condition when second ball is at rest. So their velocity will be obtained by this formula. But there is one important result in this. What is that? In this second condition, we are applying one more special condition. That is, if both ball have equal mass, condition of 1M. In that condition, see how this formula changes. So when it is changes, see in this equation M1 and M2 is equal, so V1 becomes 0 and V2 becomes what's u, so it becomes u1. See, this is important result combined representing here. Ball A is in motion, collides with ball B at rest. So after collision what? So ball A will be rest and ball B will be in motion of the velocity of ball A. So this is the, see the strange result here in this case. Let what is extent? This can also be asked to prove it. When a ball of mass equal mass moving with velocity collides with rest ball of same mass, although I have explained equal mass, then as a result, what is the result? See by the blue pen here, ball A becomes at rest and ball B starts moving with velocity of ball A. So this is important, very important result here in the collision in one dimension, and this result has a great mean in the physics also, right? So these are the two important results here. So we can apply a number of results, more than two, after applying the different conditions and going through the equation 8 and 9, and then the some more strange result can be obtained. So this is for today only. Have a good day to all.